honor of introducing another important ally to the LGBT community, Harry Van Doornmalen. As country general manager of IBM Netherlands and also the chairman of IBM Europe, Harry has been a true advocate for LGBT rights. So please join me in welcoming Harry Van Doornmalen.
So, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, because where I live normally it's evening already. But, you know, it's a great world. Albert Einstein once said, you have to make up your mind whether you see this world as a friendly or as an unfriendly place. And if you've made up your mind, you can decide what to do. Build walls or build bridges. And I think what we're trying to do in the next 3 days, and we're not trying to do, we are going to do it, is to build bridges in this really becoming truly global world we're entering. And what we have in mind today is to share with you simply experiences, lessons learned, testimonials. And we really do hope that when you leave here in 3 days from time, your notebook is filled with some new ideas so that you, in your own environment, can use them, excite people, and choose people, you know, and make that work. So what I have in mind in sharing with you is basically the following. I will tell you, you know, why we think at IBM LGBT is so important. I will share some ideas on how we're doing that. And finally, I do an appeal on all of our leadership, if you will, to see what we can do even better. So a very important first lessons we learned at IBM, that it's so important that there is a strong policy in the company. So we are extremely proud that in 1953, you know, close to 50 years ago, one of our first CEOs, he declared a policy letter. And in this policy letter, he made it very clear that he, as the senior leader at IBM, appreciates mixed teams, diverse approaches, and he wants his managers, you know, to apply that in the company. So look in your own companies. Do you have somewhere something like a policy statement? If not, don't worry, but create one. Use some examples of other companies who've done it. Policy statements, extremely, very important. So I'd like to share with you why we're doing this, how we're doing that, and our leadership statement. Now let's take a small tour in the world. A few years ago, 5 to 10 years ago, we thought that India and China were going to be the nations that were growing 5%, 10%, 20%, and we thought, well, we never see them back. Guess what? Even these countries have their share of challenges with, for example, their infrastructure. We thought that the Europeans, always accused of not having leadership, were really sinking. We saw Greece, we saw Portugal, we saw Italy. And listen, there is an amount of issues, but the European Union is regrouping, giving new direction, new statements, you know, and step by step we are climbing up the ladder. And the only thing we need to do in Europe is to really truly become a single market, because that's where our benefit. America, we even thought for a while, that America, you know, with so much deficit, finally came in a lot of problems. And you have a fair amount of challenges as well. But what I also do admire enormously in Americans is your fighting spirit. Never give up. A ton of issues, but we're going to fix this economy. You know, and that is what I see in the American environment. South America, Brazil, very strong nation, you know? They have oil and gas, you know, under their salt layer. But guess what? If the Brazilians find a way to get this oil and gas to the surface, they will be a very strong economy. I've been most recently in Turkey. I learned in Turkey about 35% of the people are below 30 years of age. So we are facing aging issues in the States and also in Europe. Well, you have these upcoming economies. And if America will be successful, and they will, in their scaly gas project, and you can tell to the Middle East, we don't need your oil anymore, you know, guess what kind of changes this is going to lead to into the world. So my point is basically why I'm using this introduction is that something is happening in this world. And my statement is, now it's really getting interesting. We are moving from 6 to 9 billion people. We have a ton of challenges. We have scarcity in money, in energy, in water, in mineral soon. So my point is, we are really, really going to need all the talent we have in this world, all the talent and more, to face these challenges and remain a good world. And that is why the focus on diversity, LGBT, but diversity as a whole, is so important. So really see this in the context of what is happening in the world. And I truly see it is becoming an open, a global world. The internet is there. If something is happening now in Australia, we know in a second. So that is the context in which we are going to operate. So, and that is really, I think, important to understand. What IBM has done as an example in preparing for that world is that 8 years ago, we started moving into an area of a globally integrated enterprise. So what does it mean? A lot of companies have their is an international community or multinationals. We have moved to an open world. And we do these things there in the world where they can be done in the best place. So we do our HR services from Budapest. We do our fulfillment systems from Madrid. We do our call centers from Africa. So in other words, again, underpinning the open world we are in and getting ready for that environment. But that said, and now I go back to LGBT specifically, this is another reality. So there's a beautiful world. There's an open world, tons of challenges, but also a world that has this reality, that in huge parts of the world, LGBT, you know, has death penalties. So here we are, with all our maturity, with all our great inventions, with our technology, and we still collectively have not been able to find a solution for this one. And that is also the reason why we're here today, to talk about it, how we can do it, you know, because that's our obligation. If we don't do it, you know, maybe nobody does. So that's why our leadership and accountability is so huge. Okay, another fact that you see is also, you've seen these percentages in different ways, that LGBT people in general, you know, don't feel safe enough in their environment. I mean, they feel offended. They don't feel happy. They feel trusted. And these percentages are 50, 60% still. You know, and those are also, you know, facts and figures we need to realize when we enter those 3 days. Why we are doing that as well? Because there's this world, because we have these challenges, because there are so many things that are not good yet, but we're also doing that because the marketplace is asking that to us. At IBM, we see that our clients really want us to show that we have a diverse policy, if you will. And that, and now read my lips, not for the easy part, which is the gender, but also for the more difficult areas, like LGBT. Last week, I talked to that in a second, I was as a transgender event in Europe. And I realized it one more time, how difficult it is for LGBT people, but specifically for transgender people, to live in this environment, you know? So we learn over time that our clients appreciate that we as a company take care and we do something about it, we acknowledge it. So the why is because the marketplace is requesting that, but also internally, people enroll to IBM because they see that we have a strong policy. Policy not only in lip service, but also in our actions and the way we behave. A previous CEO of IBM, Mr. Lou Gerstner, once gave a definition on culture. And he said, culture is something you do when nobody is looking. Culture is something you do when nobody is looking. So it's just normal. It's in your DNA. It is as if, what else do you mean? So in the internal company IBM, people feel proud when they enroll that we have such a policy. And also, and that's an open door, but we know that diverse groups, you know, sometimes are irritant because everybody has an opinion, but in the end, it's good. Diverse thoughts come to better results. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is a little bit why we are doing this. Because of this world, because our clients are asking that, but also because our internal members and even our partners want us to do that. So today, HP, and who was applauding so hard? That was Deloitte, yeah. So today, HP and Deloitte and all these beautiful companies here are no enemies, no enemies at all, because we are bonded here by the same community. And that's what we like so much at sessions like here. We have another code to crack, if you will, and that brings us all together. So how we're doing that as IBM? Just a few, you know, maybe some ideas what you can do. First of all, this chart, like they cannot read it, but I mean, first message is, as I said before, come up with a vision. The second in this chart is, this is really going to be a journey. So at IBM in Europe, each 6 weeks, we have a discussion with all the different groups in the countries. And there was a lady in Romania one day, it was half a year ago, and she said, Harry, the highlight this year is that I will have a round table with my country general manager. Wow. A round table with you? I said, what does it mean? Is that with an audience like this or something and the country general is talking? No. The country general invited three people in his room to have a chat of an hour. The first idea, I said, well, is that it? You know, I mean, come on, we need to do better. But then I learned in that culture, in that country, with that history, this was the highlight of the year of this lady, if you will. So don't judge too fast. And we learned this is a journey. So we are proud that in the 60s, we appointed for the first time a black lady as a vice president of IBM. Then in 1984, we had equality of rights for men and women. More recently, we declared a declaration of a dress code, if you will, a dress code. And again, people say, well, what do you mean a dress code? Well, we learned that for our transgender population, issuing a dress code was more or less a next, you know, stimulation, a step up to coming to work, you know, dressed in a dress, if you will. So the message of this chart is think about some things you've done already in time, set some new targets for the period to come, and most of all, appreciate all the steps. Don't judge too early, because in some cultures in the world, things are extremely important. The next lesson we learned is our parades, and I give you some example of the European environment. So first, and out and equal must be complemented with that, we organized in early July the Auto Equal event in London. It was a great success. So many people attended, so many great speakers who also give their insights, what they learned, what they felt. A lot of what Claudia mentioned, outside discussions, because trust me, ladies and gentlemen, the network outside is even as important as us speaking to you. And Martina Navratilova spoke there as a guest of honor, and she really gave her insights, what she experienced. And of course, she is a big star, a tennis star, but she also shared with us, you know, the day-to-day challenges he had in life, you know? And seeing these people speak, it is just a delight to be part of that event. So great compliment out and equal. Another example was in Budapest and also in Bulgaria. Bulgaria's east in Europe. So for the fifth time this year, there was a parade organized, and the four always ended in riots. Always ended in riots. They started nicely and then it was over. Police, people in jail, terrible. For the first time this year in Sofia, Bulgaria, the fifth one was done in a calm way. And again, you can say, so what? That's normal. No, it's not normal in these countries. It is normal that people can go there, feel safe, feel protected, and can do their parade, if you will. So all of these examples are there that are helpful to our program, if you will. The European transgender event I talked about last week. So, I mean, I read testimonials of IBMers who are transgenders, and I picked up a few times that suicide is something that is coming to mind of transgender people so often. I didn't know that. But the testimonials of IBMers were there. A lady who wanted to transition, of course, she lost her family. Of course, she lost her kids. Of course, she lost her job. But then she was picked up at IBM, and IBM helped her with the transition with the healthcare, gave her a job. You know, she could work from home. And step by step, you know, it was a kind of regrouping. If you hear these testimonials, and I'm sure other companies have different stories, then you understand really much better what's the challenge we really need to face. And we all need to help people outside to understand this situation. Because if I didn't have read all these testimonials, maybe I shouldn't know that. Yeah. So we have a lot of people outside, straight allies, whatever you like to call them, who need to be helped by understanding what you're facing here about. So parades, message of this chart, extremely important. Companies are supporting parades. Now keep going. And the other example I like to mention, Poland. Poland, 2 years ago, the country general manager in IBM Poland, she didn't want to do it. She said, Harry, this is losing clients. We are losing clients. An IBM company, supportive of our CEO, we still have done it over there. So these are moments of truth where you need to decide, are you going all the way or are you holding back? So parades, ladies and gentlemen, I think milestones in your career, a vision statement, and parades is going to be extremely important. The other chart I simply like to share with you, not to read it, is that we at IBM, we have a maturity ladder. That means that dependent on where you are as a company, you can look to your maturity level and you can decide what are the next steps I can take. For some companies, let's face it, it's already important that they can write down on their website for their tenders, if you will, that they have a diversity policy. That's stage A, I would say. For other companies, they have executive out members. They have a policy that they like to speak about their results and about their learning. So the point I want to make, for everybody at each company, there's a level of where you are. And again, don't accuse people when they are still on level 3. That's fine. We bring them to level 2. And from level 2 to 3, et cetera, and there we go. But the maturity ladder, so we share the charts with you. Maybe that can be of help when you discuss in the next 3 days what to do in your company. Another lineup that might be help is our diversity policy. We at IBM, we distinguish diversity 1.0, 2.0, 3.0. And again, this has to do with a level of maturity. So level 3, of course, has a lot to do with inclusion. Make these things become natural, if you will. So come to us. We can help you with these programs, if you will, that we invented at IBM as well, so they can be of benefit for you all. So the final thing I'd like to speak about is then, if we understand why we want to do that, if we understand some ideas how we can do it, and a lot of people here in the room have even better ideas from that one, is then, in the end, we talk about leadership. Because my definition is where processes stop, leadership comes in. And leadership is not easy. We always talk about leadership. But leadership is that you say, listen, it needs to be done. I'm not going to wait for anybody. I'm to listen to other people, but I'm going to do it. And we will be so proud of this group here that in the next few days you mobilize yourself once more, like you have been doing all the times, all these years so well, to say, what can we do more? And some more examples we can help you with. At IBM, for the past 2 years, we published an annual report around LGBT. So we really, you know, demonstrate to the world what we have done, what worked, what the results are, and how we're doing that. So you can get copies or PDF files, whatever you prefer, of this annual report. And maybe it can be of help for you to think about how you can do that for your own company. In this LGBT report, we write down our strategic intent. And you are not surprised that the strategic intent has a lot to do with the world we are going into. This is going to be a global environment, trust me. It's an open, dynamic, innovative, global world. where our youngsters, via social media, crowdsourcing, etc., you have an opinion. So, I mean, the point is that even in our LGBT policy diversity, we need to think about what our strategic drives are. Please read it and get an opinion about it. The other thing I'd like to leave with you as well is that on a regular basis, for each year, we set specific targets. So entering the global world is a strategic target, but thinking about the community vitality, business development, workplace, for each of them, we listed some specific actions per year that we are doing. So you can learn about it as well. So I really hope that annual report, our programs for a year, can help you, you know, to form your own opinion and maybe learn something from it. And then, ladies and gentlemen, I'm coming to my closing comments. So 6 years ago, a previous manager of myself, he asked whether I could be the LGBT champion for Europe. I said, what do you mean, LGBT champion in Europe? I said, well, we need ambassadors. We need people who can talk about this subject, who are available for this subject. And I said, well, you know, what do I need to do? And the first advice he gave me, never go on stage for the first 6 months, yeah? So he said, listen, I mean, if you talk about gay people, you know, you start smiling on stage, so that's not good. So I tell it to you in my own words. I don't hide the politics here, you know. I'm not out of queuing either, so I mean, I'm just me. The point he wanted to make is try to understand what this world is about. What are really the issues and the challenges of people in diversity as a whole? You know, gender, people with disabilities. 50 plus is becoming a new, you know, area of attention. You know, minorities, but also LGBT. So, and I can only say that after these 5.5 years, I'm really so pleased that I said yes to that person, because it gained for myself a lot of insight. You know, I met so many people over the past years that helped me in understanding what this world is about and what we can do about it, basically. And because we do that, people like Claudia and myself and others, you know, can be advocates, really, truly, as we want it to be done. So that is what we learned, and so I think it was a good advice for him to set me for some education, and after that also picking up the role. The final comment I like to make is that I learned over time that these 7 things are really extremely important. So first, it is really very important that you develop a vision statement for your company. And a vision statement that is meaningful, you know, it's close to values, it's meaningful, it's not a few lines or a few words. It must be meaningful, a vision statement. Secondly, a clear policy. The policy letter I mentioned is that the CEO is writing down to his community what he wants to be done. I think it is important. In some parts of Europe, you know, cultural, it worked that way, that whatever the CEO does, they don't care. You know, that's the cultural difference we have in this world today. But for most of the world, it is important. So therefore, that's the advice. Leadership, step out. Don't go with the flow. Go with the flow. We see too many people who simply go with the flow and think other people will do it. Oh, that's not my issue. You know, make it your issue. Always think, you know, who else will do something if I don't do it? Who else? And if there's an answer, fine, join that person. But if not, pick up your leadership. You know, that's accountability. Role models. We are so pleased at IBM, and there are more companies, that we have a lot of role models. So people like Claudia, like myself, and we have many, many others who can go out in the world and tell people what we are doing. Tell people what they can learn. Give some advice. You know, be there for Q&As. Be just a friend, if you will. So these role models is extremely important, and I hope again that after these 3 days, we have more role models in this environment. Measurement, that's a typical IBM thing, you know, you trust me. Cultivate straight allies. Listen, we are here with 300 people. So this community can get bigger, you know, and we get to 400 people. But there's a huge other army that for simplicity we call straight allies. Trust me, if we can get these people better connected to our journey so that they understand that they are not afraid to ask questions, they can be strong ambassadors of what we're doing in our LGBT programs. So my advice would be reach out, come back next year with two straight allies, you know, and reach out to them. So really do it. Put it on your list. I see nobody's writing things down, so you must be great people. But anyway, so try to do that. And the final thing is go do something. Yeah, go do something. Whatever you do, go do something. That is really so important, because listening is important, learning is important, but what is even more important is what you go do. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, I'm from Europe, I'm from Holland. I can be as enjoyable as Americans, you know. But I wanted to do this pitch a little bit more in a decent way, and based on content. You know, I can be fun, don't trust me, whatever, but it is an important moment. And there's such a huge opportunity these 3 days to learn from each other. The parades I've been, the pitches I've done, you know, the transgender event I talked about recently, you know, all are things that gave so much insight. And if we can bring it together these 3 days, you know, I think we'll be good off. So first of all, I'd like to thank you for your attention and for being here. There are really, at this moment in the States, many people, hundreds of thousands of them, who are working in very difficult circumstances. So let's think about these people as well, what has happened to them. But most of all, I'd like to wish you a good conference. I'd like to wish you a good team up with people. Learn from each other. Pinch material, even from IBM. It's fine these 3 days. And on top of that, also enjoy. Really enjoy. Thank you very much.